Hello students, Festival of Board Exams is here, and unlike other festivals which bring joy and happiness to our lives, this festival unfortunately brings anxiety and stress, not only for the students but for their parents as well. And it is a duty of we teachers to help our students to get rid of these anxieties and stress. Today I am here to help you, to give you some guidelines which will help you to score good marks in mathematics 10th board. So here the first and the foremost thing which is important for mathematics paper specially is timings. You know the time allotted is 3 hours 15 minutes. 15 minutes are given to you to read. Please make best use of this time, because here you not only you have to read the questions, but you have to identify the questions which you know very well, and you have to attempt them first. There may be one or two questions which you don't know. Leave them for the last hour, but focus on what you know very well. So this is the first and very important part. Now you know this year the board has changed the question paper pattern. There are 20 questions in section A which comprise of 1 mark each. You have appeared for so many exams by now, so many pre-boards and the internal exams, that you know what is the standard of these 1 mark questions. Most of these questions are based on concepts. So your concepts should be very clear, which I am sure by now you must be thorough in all your topics. But still, before the maths paper, one day before maths paper, you should revise the summary given in NCERT book for each and every chapter. Revise that summary very well, because all the concepts which are there in the chapter are summarized in that part. It will surely help you to answer your 1 mark question. Second important thing, these 1 mark questions only for answer. No steps, no solutions required for this. So you should only write the answer neatly, correctly. One more thing, if it is an MCQ type question, there are choices given like A, B, C, D, and your correct answer is given in choice A. Don't simply write A, but write the value given along with that, so that there is no confusion for examiner to assess the question. Next is section 2. Section B has 2 mark question. Here also the questions are short answer type questions. You don't have to write many steps, not more than 4 to 5 steps you should write. Unnecessarily you are wasting your time and energy if you are writing unnecessary steps which will not give you any marks. Marks will be given only for the correct steps, which may not be more than 4 to 5. Don't write given to prove and unnecessary things here. Then comes section C and section D, which have 3 and 4 mark questions, which are very very important, and you should be very careful in writing answers for these questions. You should write each and every step needed here, because missing one step means you are missing marks for that step. So don't forget to write here given to prove, figure if it is to be drawn, construction if it is to be done, and the solution. Especially in theorems, make sure the headings that I am giving you should have been written in the solution. Like it should start with the statement, then given to prove, figure, some constructions if you are doing it, and then comes the proof. All the headings are there, then only you can attain full marks. In the end, I would like to remind you certain important points. Point number 1, try to attempt 1 question, 1 mark questions all together. Please be careful. Section A, 1 mark question, if possible, try to attempt them all together, as here you have to write only the answers. Number 2, make sure you write the question number clearly in your answer sheet. It's a very common thing, students forget to write the question number and they simply start with the solution, which is not a good practice. Do write question number in every solution in your answer sheet. Point number 3, make sure you have attempted all the questions which are there in the question paper. your answer sheet should have all the question numbers starting from question number 1 to question number 40. And last but very important point is, when you copy the figures from question paper into your answer sheet, please verify. It is very common mistakes, reading 75 and writing 57, or reading 63 and you write 93. So please check the values which you are copying from the question paper. Once you verify it, then only you attempt to solve it. So now I wind up with the hope that these tips will help you to get de-stress for your maths paper and to score very good marks in mathematics. Wish you all the best. God bless you.